so many these areas.
Pastor Robert Kayanja called for a news conference today in Kampala following a circulation of a document from Rwakafuuzi and company advocates last evening on social media demanding the pastor to give accountability for the alleged 5 billion shillings that he collected from the young people in 2015 with a promise to enable them access the youth fund from government. In this document, the youth who approached Rwakafuuzi and company advocates claimed that 3 years down the road, they've never received any money as promised by the pastor. In his response, Pastor Robert Kayanja denied the accusations first, blaming lawyer Rwakafuuzi for circulating the document on social media platforms before even approaching him. He threatened to take on Rwakafuuzi in courts of law over spreading lies against him.
What was stunning to me after reading the letter of Mr. Rwakafuuzi, which he wrote, was that I used to have a lot of high regard for that gentleman before this letter came out. You know, because that's fake news. That's not actually just fake. It's a lie. You are perpetrating a lie. You know, that somebody has collected 5 billion shillings for the youth. A person of that caliber, if everybody of that caliber start making statements that goes out to the public, it's very sad.
He, however, clarified that in 2015 he formed a youth association dubbed Version 86 Youth for National Transformation, comprising of over 1 million youth, with an intention of helping them access youth funds from government to fight poverty. But unfortunately, to date, the president's promise to give these youths fund has never been fulfilled, and they are still waiting on the president, hopefully this coming financial year.
That's why we resulted that we'll communicate on SMS if there's any information. So when the funds come in, we will invite you, we'll have a meeting. Now, every year they have their meeting in October. So in October, they're going to have a general meeting to see the way forward. We believe that this financial year, as the president has promised, that probably they will consider version 86.
But as they wait for the fulfillment of the president's directive, Kayanja noted that 50,000 shillings was collected from each of the 700 youth to be fully registered, which amounted to 350 million shillings, but not 5 billion shillings as alleged in the circulated letter. But along the way, 207 million shillings was refunded to some of the youth groups, which left the association with about 100 million shillings only. Kayanja thus called upon the youth who feel disgruntled to go and pick their money. In a telephone interview with Urban TV, Laudius Rwakafuuzi, who is said to have circulated the contested letter, said, as the lawyer, he is only waiting to deal with Kayanja's lawyers to see that his client's concerns are addressed. This report was filed by Jaliat Namoya for Urban TV.